Yeah, good morning students. So today we are in class 6 maths, chapter number 5, listening elementary shapes, part number 2. In previous part we have discussed about the geometry box, how to use the measuring the line segments, how to measure the angles, and now we will understand about the perpendicular lines. So first of all we have to see some this board. This board has a line. There are two lines, one and one. This one. So whenever you have seen your book, this is a duster. You can see, and duster there are two lines. So what is the angle? This one. This is 90 degree angle. So whenever two lines make 90 degree angle. These lines are called perpendicular lines. So they may be made, this is a book, and there are 90 degree angles. So these lines AB is perpendicular to BC. So AB is perpendicular to BC. Why? Because they make 90 degree angles. So see your table. There are square table or rectangular table. You will find two edges, and two edges making 90 degree angle. So they are also perpendicular to each other. Now this is suppose plus sign, and they are also making 90 degree angles. So these are perpendicular lines. Suppose this is line A, B, this is line C, D. So AB perpendicular on CD. So this is the symbol of perpendicular. This is the symbol of perpendicular. Right? So whenever two lines intersect or meet each other at 90 degree angle, they call perpendicular lines. Now we understand different types of triangles. Now we discuss about types of triangle. Types of triangles. So there are so many different types of triangle. Triangle is a closed shape which is made by three line segments. Right? So basically there are two types of triangle. First is based on size, and second is based on angles. Based on size and based on angles. So first we understand about size. This is A, this is B. Now based on sides, it means we will discuss, we will categorize the triangles on based on sides. So see this triangle PQR. If this is 5, this is 5 centimeter, this is 5 centimeter. So if a triangle has three sides equal, same length, 5, 5, 5. So this is called equilateral triangle. equilateral triangle. So what is three sides have same length, right? You have to note down three sides have same length. Second is isosceles triangle. Second is isosceles triangle in which any two sides are same. Any two sides are same. Only two sides are same. Okay. So this is only two sides are same length. So this is called isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle. So if a triangle has two sides equal length, same length, like 6 centimeters, 6 centimeters, and third side may be any other side, different side. So it is called isosceles triangle. Okay, so this is the second type of triangle. Now, third, if a triangle has all three sides different, like suppose this is 10 centimeter, this is 9 centimeter, and this is 3 centimeter, all three sides have different length. Now, this is called scaling triangle. Scaling triangle. So what we note down? All three sides have different length. Okay. So let's revise. First triangle, equilateral triangle, in which all three sides are same. This is called equilateral triangle. Equi means equal. Lateral means sides. Equal sides. Now, if a triangle is only two sides are equal, so this is called iso. Iso means two. Scales, measurement. Right? Iso, two sides have equal measurement. This is called isosceles triangle. Third, scaling triangle. Scaling triangle means all three sides have different length. So this is the category, all the three triangles on the basis of different, on the basis of sides. Now we discuss the triangles types on the basis of angles. First, acute angle triangle. Acute angle triangle. So, I think you guess, if all the three angles are acute angle, suppose this is 30 degree, this is 80 degree, and this is 70 degree. So, what we note down? All three angles are acute angles. It means less than 90 degree. So all the three angles are 90 degree in a triangle, then it is called acute angled triangle. Angled. Note down A-N-G-L-E-D. Angled. This is not angle. Angled triangle. Second is right angled triangle. Right angled triangle. So right angle means 90 degree. It means, okay, can you guess how many right angles can be in a triangle? 2, 1 or 3? Yes, only 1. Because the sum of all three angles is 180 degrees. This property you will learn in next class. Okay? But you have to remember that all three angles sum is cannot be more than 180. So if one angle is 90, then other two will be acute angle. It means less than 90. So keep in mind, if one angle is 90 degree, then it is an acute angle triangle. So if one angle is 90 degree, then triangle is called acute angle triangle. Now third is obtuse angle triangle. In obtuse angle triangle, you guess one angle should be obtuse angle. It means more than 90 degrees. So let's make a more than 90 degree. Can you see this is a more than 90 degree? So this triangle is obtuse angle triangle. Only one angle. Only one angle should be obtuse angle. Right? So again in brief, first is acute angle triangle. All the three angles should be acute angle. Right angle triangle, only one angle should be 90 degree. Third, obtuse angle triangle, one angle should be 120 degree. So this was the categorization on based on angles. Based on angles, and this was on based on size. So total, we have understood six types of triangle. First, based on size, then based on angles. So I think you understand different types of triangles. Now we take different topic. Yeah. Now we take different topic, which is quadrilateral. I think everyone of you know how what is the meaning of quadrilateral. Think about that, what is mean by quadrilateral. Quadrilateral is a closed shape which is made by four lines angle. There are so many different diagrams, objects which are the in quadrilateral shape. So quadrilateral, your book is a quadrilateral shape because it has four sides. Your geometry box has four sides, so it is a quadrilateral. Your duster is a quadrilateral shape, four sides, 1, 2, 3, 4. Your window has four sides, so any four sides has polygon which has only four sides, then it is called quadrilateral. Quadri means four. What do you mean by quadri? Quadri means four. Lateral. Lateral means sides. So a polygon which has four sides is called quadrilateral. Now we understand different types of quadrilateral. types of quadrilateral. First is square. Okay, you know about the square, very common. Square is four sides, but four sides and all four angles are 90 degree. This is 10, 10, 10 and 10. Suppose these are the meters. Now, and all four angles should be 90 degree. All four angles should be 90 degree. So you have to mention in this all sides and angles are equal. Second thing, what about that zone? Yes, diagonals are, can you guess, diagonals are equal or different? Yes, equal, are equal, and bisect means they divide in equal parts, half of this point. So diagonals of square bisect each other at intersecting point. Second is rectangle. There are so many different types of objects which has rectangular shape, which faces are rectangular. Okay, your shoe box, any box, your table, your window, okay, your book may be a rectangular shape. Now, what is the special thing in rectangular? Rectangle may be like this, and this is also. So these all three shapes are rectangle. Now we will see in rectangle only opposite sides are equal. So we mention here only opposite sides are equal, right? Only opposite sides are equal. And all angles, can you guess all angles? 90 degree, very good. All angles are 90 degree. So we mention here, all angles are right angles. Right angles. Right angle means 90 degree. Now can you think about diagonals? Yeah, diagonals are equal or different? See this diagram. Yes, diagonals are equal. So you mention here, diagonals are equal and bisect each other. Diagonals are equal and bisect each other. Bisect each other means same, just like square, dividing in equal parts. So, can you guess what is the difference between the square and rectangle? First main difference I think you note down. In the square, four sides equal, but in this, only opposite side are equal. And in the square, it is a symmetrical diagram. But rectangle is not a symmetrical diagram. Yep, the symmetry chapter is the next symmetry chapter in your book. You will learn later. So this is the two types, first square and then rectangle. Now we will understand about the third type, which is the parallelogram. So we note down here, we have to remember. move this one. Parallelogram, what is the mean by parallelogram? Suppose you have a wired rectangle. Wired rectangle means wires made by wire. If you bend the rectangular, suppose this is your rectangle, if you bend like this, you will get a parallelogram. So let's make a diagram. P, Q, R, S. This is a parallelogram. In parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. First thing you note down, opposite sides are equal. Right? Opposite angles are equal. Opposite angles are equal. Second, diagonal. In parallelogram, you can observe this is very much big and this is small. So, diagonals are not equal. Diagonals are not equal, right? So parallelogram is a quadrilateral in which diagonals are not equal. And can you think they bisect each other or not? Yes, absolutely. Diagonals bisect each other. Diagonals bisect each other, right? So can you guess what is the difference between the rectangle and parallelogram? In rectangle, opposite sides are equal. In parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. Yeah. In rectangle, all the angles are 90 degrees. But in the parallelogram, only opposite angles are equal. Only opposite angles are equal. So, this is the parallelogram. Now we talk about rhombus. Okay. Suppose you have a square. Okay? A square which is made by wire. And you bend down this square. You bend down the square. So this is a rhombus. So make a diagram. Have you seen Kajupatli? See it? Yeah, very good. This is a rhombus. Or this is also a rhombus. So in parallelogram and rhombus, the parallelogram all sides are not equal, but in rhombus all sides are equal. Okay, all sides are equal. So we note down all sides are equal. Second thing, opposite angles are equal. So we note down opposite angles are equal. Right? Now, can you guess the diagonal about the, what is the diagonals are equal or different? Yes, you can see this is very much large and this is small. So diagonals are not equal. Diagonals are not equal. And they bisect each other? Yes, definitely they bisect each other. Diagnose, bisect each other. Right? So what is the difference between parallelogram numbers? Only one difference, that in parallelogram only opposite sides are equal, but in rhombus all sides are equal. Okay? So what is the difference between square and rhombus? In square all the four angles are 90 degree, but in rhombus only opposite angles are equal and rest of them same. So four types of quadrilateral we have understood: parallelogram, rhombus, square, rectangle. And next is trapezium. So fifth number is trapezium. Trapezium is a quadrilateral in which only one pair of opposite sides are parallel. So suppose this is P, Q, R, S. So you can see P, Q is parallel to RS. Only one pair of opposite sides are parallel, not equal, parallel. So only one pair of opposite sides are parallel. So this is a property of trapezium. Maybe suppose you will ask, sir, this is a parallelogram. Yes, this is only, these sides are parallel. So it is also a trapezium. You will say, sir, this is also a parallelogram. Yes. We require only one property, that only one pair of opposite sides are parallel. So in these whole diagrams, one sides are parallel. One pair of opposite sides are parallel. So you have to remember only one thing in trapezium. Only one pair of opposite sides are parallel. Now our next topic is polygons. Poly means more than two. Poly means more than two. Bonds. Bonds means sides. So if you take three sticks and join each other to make a cross shape, so what will you get? Absolutely, you will get a triangle. So this is the first polygon. This is the first polygon having three sides. Can you make a polygon by two sides? Can you make a polygon by two sides? Not possible. Closed shape, not possible. So, first polygon is made by three sides, right? Second is quadrilateral. What is quadrilateral? And it is made by four sides, right? Just now you have understood this topic very deeply. Third is pentagon. What is pentagon? Have you seen some tiles on surface in ground, playground also, anywhere, in hospitals? This type of shape tiles. This is called pentagon, and this has five sides, right? It may be regular, it may be irregular. Regular means each side equal. Irregular means may be different. Now, next is fourth, hexagon. Hexa means six, gon means sides. So a polygon which has six sides is called hexagon. So how many sides? Six sides. As you can find heptagon, octagon, right? So heptagon has seven sides. Octagon eight sides. I'm making the diagram here, you can see. Second is quadrilateral, third is pentagon, fourth is hexagon, fifth is heptagon, and sixth is octagon. Clear? So our topic is complete today. So next, one topic is remaining, 3D shapes, we will cover in third part. Thank you.